ChatGPT is a revolutionary AI from OpenAI. It was launched on 30th November 2022. And currently on its website, it has more than 25 million users every day. From explaining quantum computing in simple terms to writing an email, letter, or an essay for you, it can do a lot of amazing things. Similarly, today in this video, we will be analyzing data with the help of ChatGPT. Here, we will be using Python libraries to analyze data. So hello everyone and a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain and as I said, in this video we will be using ChatGPT to analyze data. Here we will be asking it to use the three libraries, that is NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib. First of all, we won't be telling ChatGPT to use which libraries. Let's see which library it suggests and later we can give more suggestions according to our choice. So let's get started, guys. So guys, this is how the first page of ChatGPT looks like. You need to log in over here with your Google account. And once you log in, this is the first page. So my first question over here would be, how to analyze data using Python? Explain it with an example of a code. Let's press enter. And here our answer is already Sal. It says that analyzing data using Python is a powerful skill. And it's creating a data set for a small business. It has following columns, that is date, product, price, quantity, and revenue. So it's using Pandas and Matplotlib over here. Let's wait for it to complete the code and then I'll explain you each step one by one. So our first step over here was to import Pandas as PD and import Matplotlib.pyplot as PLT. That means we need to install these two libraries. After that, it has defined the figure size and the font size. Then we have used Pandas to read a sales data.csv, but we don't know where is this sales data. But anyways, so we have this sales data.csv. In this, we have total revenue, average price, total quantity, total sales, product stats, and product stats again. So here it has used group by and aggregate function so that we can aggregate the data. Now let's do one thing, let's ask it for a data set as well, as without data there is no sense of doing a visualization. So I'll be asking that provide the data set for the above code as well. So as you can see, it has already started creating a CSV file which has date, product, price, quantity and revenue, which was mentioned earlier over here on the top that we will be having date, product, price, quantity and revenue as our small data set for a small business. Let's wait for it to finish and then we will start pasting this code, start pasting this data in our Excel as well. Meanwhile, I'll open Excel. Let's open a blank workbook. Let's wait for it to finish. It has also told us to save this data as salesdata.csv so that we can use it with our Python script. Let's copy this code. Let's go to Excel. I'm going to paste it over here. Now I'll be selecting all these columns. I'll go to data tab. I'll use text to columns. So these are separated with commas. That's why I'll be using delimited. Let's click on next. Here my comma will be how everything has been separated. Let's click on next. And lastly, let's click on finish. And now you can see everything that was separated with a comma is now in here like this. So we have this. Let's save it as well. And for saving it as, we'll go to the same location where our Python file is. Or what you can do is you can save it at whatever location you want, and when you are opening the file in the Python script you need to pass that location. So for me, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to save it to the same directory where my Python file is saved. So I'll be saving it over here by writing data underscore, actually it's sales data, so I'll be writing sales underscore data dot csv. Let's press enter and it has been saved over here at our location. Now all we need to do is to go to our Python code. In our Python code, first of all, let's open ChatGPT. So I'll be opening ChatGPT over here. Let's start with installing these libraries. So it has not told us to install these libraries, but I'm just recommending you to install Pandas and install Matplotlib before you use these codes. So let's copy this code and let's paste it here. Let's copy this one where we will be reading all the files. So we have a salesdata.csv, which is probably here. So here we have salesdata.csv on our left. Let me just increase a size a little bit more. and then we will be copying all the data from here. So in the next part of code, what we have done basically is that we are analyzing the data. We are calculating some basic statistics here. So let's copy this code. Let's go back in here. Let's paste it. So here what we have used is total revenue, average price, total quantity, and total sales. In the next part of code, we have used pandas to group by the elements based on the product, and then we have find the aggregate values of revenue, quantity, date. So revenue is based on sum, quantity is based on sum, and the date is based on count. Let's copy this code. Let's go back to PyCharm and let's paste it here. In our next part of code, now that we have our statistics, let's visualize them. To visualize the data, it has used matplotlib. In the matplotlib, we are going to plot a bar plot, as we can see over here. So let's copy this code and again let's paste it here. Lastly, our last step would be to visualize data to understand the relationship between the price and the quantity sold. So we'll be copying this code and again we'll paste it over here. Let's run and see how the output looks like. So as soon as I'll run it, nothing happens because it has also not given us another command, that is plt.show. So we need to add plt.show. And again, if I rerun this program, so after writing plt.show, let's run it again. And now as soon as I'll run it, it will show me a bar graph which is plotted between product A, product B, and product C. It's between the price and the quantity sold. This is how we have got the outputs. If just in case you want to know all the other values as well, what you can do is where we have found the sum of revenue, the sum of the mean value, the sum value, the count value, you can print these values in the Python as well. So by writing print total revenue here, by writing print average price, print total quantity, and lastly print total sales. And as soon as I run it once again, so these are our answer. This is the average value. The first one is our sum, the sum of the revenue. The second one is our average price. The third one is our total quantity, that is 69. And lastly, total sales is there, which is 14, which is the count of a date. So even you will notice over here that here there are still some mistakes which needs to be fixed by a person who better knows Matplotlib, NumPy, and pandas. So when people ask this kind of a question that will ChatGPT will replace the jobs completely, the answer is no, because as you can see over here that this was the code which I copied from ChatGPT. Still it had so many mistakes. I had to use plt.show to show the bar graph. It has not given us the name of the libraries to install in our command prompt. Next, it has not printed any of the values to find the aggregate values as well. And even this part of the code doesn't make any sense, because this will not give our total sales over here, but total number of dates would be what it should have been. But it has given us total sales as the count of date, so which is again wrong here. So even if you want to use ChatGPT to find the answers of your questions, still you need to have a little knowledge on that topic. It will not directly give you all the answers, but you need to have a little knowledge on each of the things. So I hope guys that this video was clear to you, and if you like it, do like, share, and subscribe. And for more such content, stay tuned guys. Thank you.